Okay, so here's the thought. Coming up soon is the Tesla Semi event, and I'm wondering, does Elon and team have something else in mind? Now, we already know they're planning a pickup truck, but this is just thinking that I'm going to be throwing out there. And all right, here's what I'm kind of putting together here. Now, I know it's not comparing apples to apples exactly, but could Tesla very easily make a miniature, I guess, semi, or even a multi-purpose pickup truck? Because if you think about it, pickup trucks contribute to a lot of vehicular sales in North America, US, Canada. I don't know so much around the rest of the world, but I know in the US and Canada, pickup trucks are a very versatile vehicle. So let's, for starters here, let's just throw out some numbers and then I'll explain away. The P100D puts out approximately 588 horsepower and has approximately 920 foot-pounds of torque. Now, mind you, the P100D is also designed for getting up to high speeds very quickly at that. So with a little bit different gear ratio in the differentials, you could get considerably more torque out of these, out of those motors, and that's just a dual motor car. Next, if you take a look at the average semi-truck, an average semi-truck is going to put out approximately 400 horsepower and 1,300 foot-pounds of torque. Oh, 400 to 500 horsepower for an average semi-truck and 1,300 foot-pounds of torque, roughly. And just for reference, FedEx has a rough limitation of 500 horsepower maximum for corporate and owner operators, which means people that own their own semi truck and are contracted by FedEx. Just to throw that out there. So what am I getting at? What I'm getting at is, and we already know it, Teslas have, and electric motors and electric vehicles in general, have an insane amount of torque. And we already know, based on what Tesla's told us, Tesla's going to be using the same motors on the Tesla Semi as in the Model 3. So they're actually going to be permanent magnet motors, not AC induction motors like what's on the existing ones. Permanent magnet motors are great and put out lots of power at lower speeds or lower power demand. When you want performance for blistering RPMs, that's when you go to AC induction motors. Now, they could go either way with this, but just a thought, a dually pickup truck, if Tesla made a dually pickup truck or a pickup truck with dual rear axles and a motor on both rear axles and a motor on the front axle, Tesla could easily surpass the torque required that a semi-truck requires. The only problem then would be how much battery power, which, I mean, right now all the battery packs for the Model S and X are standardized. And the Model 3 has a different design battery pack. So the S and X use the same design battery pack and same cells. The Model 3 uses a larger cell and a, you know, physically different shape battery pack to fit the Model 3, its smaller stature, which isn't much smaller. So if you think about it, we have 100 kilowatt hour battery packs already from the Model S and the X. Now, a Tesla pickup truck, I would say, would be at least the size of an X, if not a little bit larger, or at least longer, and probably higher too. Most pickup trucks are going to be a little higher off the ground. So, you know, they could do something that's maybe a double stacked, and this isn't even considering what future energy density might be, but like a double stack pack, you're talking then, if they're using the same packs that the S and the X are still using, you're still talking then 200 kilowatt hours, or a triple stacked if the vehicle's up high enough. Now you're talking 300 kilowatt hours of capacity, and that's 300 kilowatt hours of capacity is quite a bit. Now, a mini pickup semi truck, or in this case, a beefed up pickup truck instead of a mini semi truck, think fifth wheel trailers or gooseneck trailers. You got the hitches mounted right into the bed of the pickup truck, and it's got the gooseneck coming down and over, which is similar to how a semi-truck hauls, and I've seen single, non-dually, single rear axle pickup trucks pulling car haulers with five or six cars on them. So, I mean, you got the power. Diesel vehicles and gas vehicles are already pulling gooseneck and fifth wheel trailers. So that was just my thought, you know, pinging around in my head. If you could have three motors, maybe a little bit different gear ratio to allow the motors to run at a higher RPM, while still, you know, a little more, you know, lowering and also increasing the torque, higher RPM, you know, playing with the gear ratio. I think it would actually be fairly simple for Tesla to put out something that would be a excellent tractor trailer puller. What are your thoughts? Comment in the description box below. Let's keep this clean for those of you out there that are just joining us from the gas and diesel community. You know, things are changing. There's no stopping it. Electric's here to stay. Let's make it work for everyone. So what are your ideas? We'll revisit this again after we get a good number of comments, and I'll read off some of the ideas and see if we can come up with some neat solutions, maybe get Tesla moving along, because even they're missing out on a big market share too, not having a pickup truck out there. I know a lot of people that would switch to Tesla if they could get a pickup truck. Yeah, and or even something that has a little bit more towing capacity. Just with my own experience, the amount of range reduction on a Model S towing, which is most of the range reduction is due to drag, not weight of the trailer, the car has more than enough power to pull anything out there. I have seen a Model S, not a Model X, a Model S pull a 10,000 pound trailer, not very far, just because... No, it was not me, especially if Tesla, if you're watching this, so I don't go voiding any warranties. No, I did not pull a 10,000-pound trailer with my Model S, but I have seen it. I promise not to take pictures because they didn't want their warranty voided. It was kind of a necessity thing, a 10,000-pound trailer, and they let me try it too, and you couldn't even tell it was behind the car. That's how insane the power is on a Tesla vehicle. Just for starters, it's the range problem. So 100 kilowatt hour pack isn't going to cut it for pulling a 20 or 30,000 pound trailer, not by a long shot. But a 200 kilowatt hour pack, I think that would be great. I mean, I know lots of people that drive from Milwaukee to Chicago, or Chicago to Milwaukee, Milwaukee to Chicago, doing certain runs. I mean, that's it's a 75, 80 mile each way trip. And I think that would be perfectly doable with a 200 kilowatt hour pack. Just thinking out there. So weigh in your opinions and let's get this discussion going.